Howdy, folks, and welcome to a new series of Let's Dick Around. We're going to be playing around in Dwarf Fortress. Now, I know I said I was going to wait until the next update before I started doing anything with it, but the Toady One seems to be on another one of his year-long update schedules, so I don't see any update forthcoming, so I figured I might as well just do something here. Normally when you begin a game of this, you generate a world, but I already did that because I tend to generate large old worlds, so they take like 15-20 minutes to generate. So that's already done, and we're going to play in adventure mode as opposed to fortress mode, because I have not, like, played this game since... Oh man, I think it was version, like, 2.8. Like, 4.8D or something. It was a long time ago and a lot has changed, so we're just going to jump into adventure mode and pray I don't die. And today's music is by Jennifer Wang, Rob King, and some other folks. It's from Might and Magic's 6 and 7, so we're going to jump right in here. Okay, start playing adventure. And we are importing our mega world. Okay, so the first thing we do here is we have to choose our race, and the races that you're provided with are dependent upon the regions generated in the world. So we've got some humans, some elf scum, and some badass dwarves. We're actually going to play a human, and we can be a peasant hero or demigod. I assume that affects like your starting power. We're actually going to go with demigod, because I'm probably going to die horribly. And we will start in Dur Orspa. Oh wow, this is way different. Okay, we're gonna play a fighty melee, I'm gonna smash your face in with a sword type character. So we shall up our strength score. Okay, do a couple points in toughness and endurance, some above average recuperation, up our agility, do our willpower and focus. We can actually lower them, but it's only like a couple points, so that's hardly worth it. We're going to lower our empathy, and we don't care about music, and we don't need to speak other languages, and our patience is short. And with that, we're going to up our disease resistance, and our intuition, and up our recuperation to high. Okay. Now for our skills, the first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to want to know how to swim. We'll be an adequate swimmer, because you drown in this. It's like it used to be, you drown. We'll be a proficient, talented swordsman. We'll be good with some armor, good with shields. Dodging can be dangerous, but we're going to be competent at it. And we're also going to be competent at wrestling. I think we're also just, like, I don't know if you, like, fighter, okay? I assume that's, like, unarmed fighter. So we're gonna leave that where it is. We're actually gonna pump our armor up to be higher. There. We have 6 points left. We will put a point in an ambusher. Alright, done. Okay, we are Lichteshiluda, Lick Talon Hips. Okay then, let's random name again here. Sason Helm Confuse. Oh, there we go. C2 Twinkle Soldier. That is our demigod. And we shall enter the world. And. Alright, you finally got your equipment together, and such as it is, now it's time for action and adventure. In the rush of excitement, you've forgotten where you were going to go. Perhaps some of your friends here have ideas. Press ? For help. Alright, now as you guys can see, this game does not exactly have state of the art graphics. It is a roguelike kinda, so it's all ASCII art. I don't have a tile set installed, so everything is fairly straightforward looking. But I do use the 16 by 16 pixel tiles instead of the, I think it's like 16 by 10. So everything's on a nice even square grid. Alright, so for those that have never played a roguelike, I'll give you guys a breakdown here. Right now, what we're standing in is most likely fields. We can like look here. Furrowed clay, okay. These are hills right here, and they're going upwards because it's pointing up. This is a wall right here, and this is like grass out here. And these are like solid walls, probably like loam or sand, peat wall, and clay. Alright. So let us see what we can find here. Okay, this is a door, which we are going to open, and there's a person inside. A brewer. Let us approach him, and I think T is talking. No, T is throw. T. No. Oh, damn it. Go back down. Alright. Question mark. Key bindings. Where's talk? K. Okay. Okay. Him. You begin a conversation with the brewer, Osprum Dukaukki. Alright. We'll greet him. Hello, Osprum. It is good to see you. Traveling alone in the wilds, you know better than that. Let's ask him about the surroundings. Tell me about this area. The reclusive tower is half a day's travel to the southwest. In 7, the dwarf Atir Quickink was struck down by the rock Muso Bird's Leopards, the oaken roots in the reclusive tower. Oh, so there might be a powerful foe there. Okay, can we help you with anything? Discussing your cause. A particular outlaw has been causing hardship. Okay. Sleeve Blotted is a short walk to the northwest. Alright, goodbye. I'm surprised you didn't, like, tell me to worship murder or anything. Alright, so short walk to the northwest. Let's see, what's a T? Alright. Now, when they say short walk, they don't mean a literal short walk. It's because a short walk to the northwest is still in town. This is like a city here, and this is the overworld map, for those that haven't gotten that yet. These are roads, the blue is rivers, these are like little towns. I think that is our quest right there, the little gold dit on the map, and you've got like fields and stuff. That's like a little site, that's a tower, I believe. That's probably that tower he was telling us about. So we're going to head to the west, but I'm going to check to make sure that we are going where we want to be going. Kill Slimin. Alright, I am here. Let's see, zoom to... selected. Alright, it is to my northwest, so I'm going to assume that this is it. And you can see the day is passing on the top of the screen. You cannot travel through the camp. Okay, this is the place. So we'll go down in. Actually, I'm going to see what weapons I have here. Alright, I've got a bronze short sword and an iron shield. And then I've got some general gear. Okay, so I'm going to assume that... Alright, as you can see, it tells us where our stuff is. Our task is to the west, so that's where we're going to want to go. We're going to be careful, though. I would like to find some... That's exactly what I wanted to find. I want to pick up some pebbles. There, 5 of them. You can use them to distract people, or... I am Simon Drilldlaws. Prepare to die. Alright, just because they said that doesn't mean they see us. Although, I have a feeling since we're in a more or less flat plain that they did. What do we have here? She carries a silver maul and a copper shield. Doesn't appear to be too well armored, though. So, if we're careful, we might be able to kill her before she can butcher us with that hammer. However, I don't know if she's seen us or not. Has she seen us? Yes. Okay. I should have put some points into throwery. We are going to throw a dolomite rock in her general direction. And I think we just completely blew that. Alright, we're gonna kind of dance around here, wait for her. Because by the looks of things... Alright, we are faster than they are. I can't tell. Alright, it is a female, so we are faster than she is. Okay, just wanted to make sure. Alright, come on, get close to me. Okay. So we're going to, I think it's shift A. Alright, we are going to aim our attack at the warlord. Now this is a new thing where you can actually choose where you're going to strike in like different attacks or different things. So you could hit her in the leg and it'd be an easy attack but would land fairly solid. Or we could go for her head, which would be a more difficult strike, but could possibly kill her in one strike. We're actually going to try for that. We attack head and we are going to... stab her in the head with our bronze short sword. She jumps away. Ah. Alright, go on. Okay, let's try this again. What does she have open? We'll stab her in the left foot. It's an easy strike and will be a fairly solid one. So stab her. You strike at her, but the shot is blocked. She counterattacks and misses us as we jump away. Alright. Come on, we're dancing around here. Okay, looks like we're just gonna try and slash her in her left upper arm here. You charge her, but we miss, and we collide with her and knock her to the ground. Seeing an opportunity here, we are actually going to stab her in the right foot again, attempting to. She loses her... Oh, we stab her in the right foot with her brunch. Oh my god, knocking her to the ground, we stab her in the foot with our sword and do it so in such a way that we sever her foot from her body and it flies off in a bloody arc. So now she's probably bleeding pretty heavily. A prone warlord and a few objects and a pile of vomit. Oh, she threw up away from the pain. And yes, she's bleeding. Oh, we cut her hand off. No, we cut her foot off. As you can see, it's dark. That means that it is not there anymore. Strange that she would... Oh, that's just status. Okay, I gotcha. So she's on the ground and bleeding heavily. Is she gonna try and... Oh, she's trying to get away from us. Well, we can't have that. Oh, she attacked us. Come on. Come on. Oh, no. Alright. Let's see if we can put her out of her misery here. Not looking like it. Definitely not looking like it. Alright, we'll just try... stabbing her in the arm. No, she blocked it. And tried to counterattack, but we easily dodged her strike. Okay, we're gonna stab her in the right upper arm. Oh, she blocked us again. She's good with that shield. We'll try for the head. We'll try cutting her head off. Nope. Come on now. Let's see here. Try another one on the head. Nope. Well, we can just, like, kind of wander around here and let her bleed to death. See what she dropped here. A shoe, a chasse, and some blood and vomit. Huh. So, how's that bleeding out working for you? Throw a rock at you. The warlord blocks the spinning small Doyle Knight rock. Alright, we're gonna throw another one at her. This is a way to train up our, throwing skill, because skills work by use in this. Oh, she rolls away from the spinning dolomite rock. Alright. We'll throw our last one at her here. Nope. Alright. Oh, and of course we're getting emails. Alright. She attacks us, but we easily evade it, and we move in to stab her. In the upper body, actually. Oh, she blocks us with her shield. She's pretty good, damn. We'll try stabbing her again. Alright, come on. Come on. Oh, she's fighting. We slash her in the lower leg with our short sword and the severed- Oh, we cut her leg off. She attacks us, but we counter-strike, but she manages to block it at the last moment. We will try... a tricky strike to the upper body with a slash. Ah, she blocks and attempts to counter strike, but we evade it. Let's see what we got here. Alright, so we're doing pretty good. I don't think she's actually even hurt us yet. We'll try another one to her upper body. Nope. Alright, we're just gonna unleash a little. We attack her and she scrambles away and in doing so bleeds to death. So ends the tales of Simon. Alright, we're gonna take that silver maul. And let's see, does she have anything else worth anything? Her mutilated corpse. I wonder if we could take her head. Not looking like it. We could take her leg. I know you used to be able to like butcher corpses. I wonder if you still can. Let us see here, it's just not looking like it. I might need, like a specific item to be able to do so. Fire projectiles... Ah, darn. That's fine though, we'll leave her here for the crows, we've got her hammer. Alright, we're gonna head back over to the overland map. And head back to where we got this quest. Which I think was somewhere down in here. We should be able to just talk to about anybody and tell them that, yeah, we took care of your monster problem. Hail, friend! Who are you? Greetings! My name is Situ Twinkle Soldier. Ah, hello, I'm Dothan Kindle Squid. The people of this town have strange names. I am here to report the slaying of a bandit that was troubling you. This is fantastic! May Simon Brilgclaws rot forever in the underworld. Well, that's what it's looking like is going to be happening. Is there anything else I can help you with? Oh, another outlaw, you say? Girl yawning is a half day's travel to the east. All right. I think we are going to say goodbye. And I'm going to hit the overland map. It is going to be getting dark soon, so we are actually going to see if he will let us stay the night at his place. Seeing as how we took care of some of his problems. Certainly it would be no trouble to leave someone fend for themselves after sunrise. Alright, after sunset. Bye. Escape. I think it's sleep for the necessary 8 hours. So we'll sleep until dawn. And you don't want to sleep outside at night. It is bad, trust me. There are things waiting for you. Is it dawn? Overworld. Yes, okay. Alright. Quest log. Alright, so we want to go to the southeast. Ah, there it is. So long as we're not fighting, like, bandit archers, we should be okay. Bandit archers are nasty, though. Okay, so I'm gonna go southwest, and I'm going to, lie prone, and I'm making sneak. There we go. So we are moving very, very slowly now by comparison to how we move normally. We're moving at about, less than a quarter of our speed. But, since I'm, trained in ambushing slightly... Okay, so she's near. Well, he or she is near. Prepare to die. But that does not mean that they have noticed us yet. Okay, to the west. Slowly slinking through the undergrowth here. And, like these, basically things shaped like playing cards or trees. There are some other things that are shaped like that are trees, but that's more or less the gist of it. South southwest. Gotta be getting close. What is this? A mule leather bag and a training sword. We're going to stand, but we're going to keep sneaking. And we're drowsy. Let's see. Ooh, we're gonna take that silver coin. Northeast. East. Okay, so this is where we wanna be. But we have apparently missed the person that we are here to kill. So they're probably around here somewhere, lurking in wait for us. So we want to be careful, kinda poking around, or they'll ambush us, which would not be a good thing. Well, heck. Come out of hiding. Alright, bandit warrior, where are you? We're tired and irritable, and we're going to butcher you if you would show yourself. Northwest. Oh yes, I know that. Right up here by her little... its little... training sword. I wonder if there's anything in that bag. Inventory! The other pages. The other bag has nothing on it. Alright, so we're gonna go with... yeah, actually, no, we'll hold on to that. We can always use some more storage. Where is this person? Come now. He must be somewhere nearby. Like, I'm actually kind of surprised that we haven't bumped into any, like, people with minions yet. Normally they'll have, like, some, other bandits and stuff with them that typically are there just to get in the way and be easily cut down. I wonder where this person is. This music is getting decidedly creepy. East, southeast, east. We found their camp. We know where their camp is. It's like here. Yes, we're on it. Last log. Kill Rhysus Tailskinny. Crisis, where are you? I'll stab you in the head with my sword. Maybe if we fight somebody that like doesn't fight with a shield, we'll probably be able to kill them better, because shield users are actually notoriously hard to kill in this game. That's actually why I'm carrying one, even though it's like, what a... Oh, we're actually a left-handed character, I didn't notice that. Interesting. But, like, you can stack shields and stuff, like, you can have one character that wears, like, four shields, but I don't intend to do that, because it's kind of, I view it as, like, abusing a bug. It just doesn't seem right. I wonder where this person is. I think this is, like, yeah, this is an open space. It looks like, alright, this is water, actually, right here. What it is it's like a pool of water, and if you go into that, you'll drown. As you can see, this shows us that one level below us, there's actual water there. So we will want to be careful around that. Especially, like, playing a character that can dodge like I do, you can, like, be fighting, like, right here, and someone will attack you, and you'll dodge into the pool and end up drowning. Had that happen before, it's not fun. Alright, this is going... Wait, what was that? Oh, that's a steam training sword. This is going nowhere. Is there anyone around here? Anyone at all? I'm trying to remember where I saw the initial, like, I'm going to kill you, signed Bandit Lord message. But I cannot find where that was. So, alright, what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna go back to the world map. We're gonna pop into this town here because it's getting dark. Been there like all day. Oh, is this a... This is like a little fort. Alright. You discovered a river. Okay. So we have. Alright. Is there any way inside here? Not looking like it. Alright, let's see what's over here. I hate having to sleep in forts because they can be dangerous to sleep in. You can bump into stuff. Horrors from beyond the beyond. Alright, this is a hamlet here. We'll try it here, see if we can get any, like, structures. Let's see here. This is not looking like a civilized place. This is not good. Alright, back to the overworld now. Alright, we'll see if we can make it up to here. Oh god. Uh-oh. We got ambushed. You're surrounded by incessant cackling. Oh yes, we have been ambushed by horrors from what do we got? A boogeyman. These things are nasty. They don't die. They chase you and they will eventually just kind of like get bored and fade away. But we are going to flee from them. If there were only like what was that? Boogeyman has vanished. You're still surrounded by cackling. If there were only like one or two of them, I'd probably stay and fight, but there are never only one or two of them. So we are fleeing through the night. We're tired and just trying to survive. I'm thankful that we're as quick as we are on our feet, because these guys are actually really fast. But I think we are at least as fast as they are, if not slightly faster. God, I'm just heading towards where the town appeared to have been on the map. Alright. We are in the town now. Oh! A boogeyman bit me. It punched me in the head, bruising my muscle through my cap. It gores you in the arm. I'm bleeding heavily. I'm going to try and step away, and it's following and still attacking me. Oh my gosh. We're going to, gores me again. I'm going to lash out and attack it here. What can we do? We're going to strike it in the hand with our shield. We missed. I don't know where my sword went. I think I lost it. That is not good. Oh, we have a mortal wound. We are going to die. Oh, they've got us. Oh, there we go. We have been struck down. A boogeyman guts us with its hand and tears our intestines out and then latches onto our throat with its maw and tears it out, and we go down. Oh wow, it actually... It ripped our throat out, but that did not kill us. It actually beat our head in with a rock. That is rough. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is Dwarf Fortress. Finish the game. truly quit, all active saves would be deleted. Well, we kinda die. So yeah, we're gonna quit. And yeah, I think we might do... we'll do one more, I think. And it says Dwarf Fortress is not responding, but I know it is, it just lags here. All that sorts of historical figures and so on and so on. But anyways, yes, that is how most characters end. You do something stupid like wander around at night and end up getting nommed on by horrors from beyond. Alright, so we're gonna jump back in as another adventurer. And we're not gonna play Demigod this time. We're just going to play a hero, and we're going to be a dwarf of Kadistakost. And we shall be very, very, very damn strong. We have superior strength. We hate music. Music is for the weak, as is empathy. And we are incredibly impatient. And we lack creativity. However, we are pretty tough and we have some good endurance. And we are going to be an axe dwarf. We are skilled with axes. We are also good with armor and shields. We're not going to go with wrestling. We'll put a couple points into dodging. I'm actually going to put a little into throwing as well. And miscellaneous object user. I don't even know what a napper is, so we're not going to put anything into that. We'll put one into observer and one into swimmer as well. Alright, and we are upon swim flag. And we're just going to jump right in with that. We are the swim flaggiest. Alright, we've got our equipment together. Let's see what we've got. A copper battle axe, iron shield, and some standard armor. We've got water and food, so we should be okay. And we appear to be in a little field. Strange that a dwarf would be seen upside the top of the world. Alright. Oh, we have a family in here, apparently. Oh, let's talk to this fellow here. He's a fish dissector. Hail, fish dissector. Hail, dwarf. I am Arta Thundertoe. How'd you get that name? Well, thunder hit my toe. How does that work? Alright, is there anything we can do to help you? A beast from the wilds has been harassing our people. The Hollow of Winnowing is nearly a day's travel to the north. Seek this place and kill Gulnas Burst Temples, the wolf. Alright, we shall do so. We have an axe, we are sure in our abilities, and we are going to head to the north and see about finding and killing this wolf. Now, as you complete quests and get more popular, you can actually recruit people to help you out. Like, they'll follow you around and you can have, like, your own party of adventurers and stuff. Uh-oh. Wolves. Wolves are nasty. Alright, we're pretty quick. But there are a lot of wolves. Do we have anything to throw? I'm not freaking Captain America throwing my shield. We're going to grab some rocks here. And we're going to pitch a shale rock. At a wolf. We miss. We're going to pitch another one. Spinning shale rock strikes the wolf in the left front leg, bruising it to the bone. Alright, we're gonna try pitching another one at it. Ooh, bruising the heart. Oh, I think we screwed that wolf up, I think. Yeah, we damaged its heart. Alright, we're gonna try and throw another one at it then, see if we can kill this stupid thing. Got it in the lung. Alright, we are faster than the wolves, so if necessary, we can... Uh-oh. Okay, I'm just making sure. I think I accidentally threw a rock at myself. I don't know. Okay. We do have a dagger on us that we could throw, but I'm not going to do that. Alright, we're gonna strike it in... we're gonna go for its leg, and we're gonna try and hack its leg off. We charge the wolf, hacking its right front leg with our battle axe, fracturing the bone and cutting open one of its arteries. It begins bleeding all over the place, and it is knocked prone by our vicious assault. We are going to kind of pull back a little bit and see if we can maim this one. We're going to snag it in the rear paw with the blade of our axe. Do we tear its freaking... Oh my god, that is horrible. We open its artery up too, Jesus. And a sensory nerve has been severed, so it's going to have some trouble following us, I think. Alright, what are you gonna do? Where are you guys? Alright, ooh, we don't have any good openings there, so we're gonna kind of pull back a little bit. We don't wanna be doing anything stupid here. We'll leave that as well. A wolf stood up. Alright, we are going to attempt to strike this one in its rear left leg. We're going to attempt to hack its leg off. We attack the wolf in the rear left leg with our copper axe, tearing apart the muscle and severing its artery. We knock it over and it tumbles backwards. While it's down, we're actually going to make another strike. We're going to try and hit its upper body. Oh, we tear a tendon in the right true rib, and I think we cracked its lung up pretty good, too. Good. Gives into pain, which more or less means it kind of passed out from the pain. They don't stay out for too long, though. What are you doing, wolf? Alright. No openings there. Ooh, a solid strike to the upper body with our axe. Ah, but she jumped away. The wolf in the rear leg with our axe, tearing apart the muscle and severing a sensory nerve. It yelps in pain. I think we're actually gonna pull away. Stupid wolves. They're nothing but trouble. We charge at the wolf, colliding with it, knocking it over as it tumbles backwards. We cut its paw a little bit, but it's a superficial wound. Why is my speed down? I don't know. Okay. We charge at a wolf, colliding with it, knocking it over, and another one jumps at us, but we manage to jump away to safety. And this one we are going to... not do anything that's really good strikes open. Oh, we charge at the wolf again, colliding once more, knocking it over. We like knocking them over. And we're going to try and sever its front paw. Or front leg, rather. Oh, we got it in the leg with our battle axe, fracturing its bone. So, we're messing these wolves up. They, even if they kill us, they will not forget their encounter with Aban, or Minsalon. Alright, we're gonna try and, cut this one's left leg off. Rear left leg. Oh, we sever the muscle and screw up its motor nerve in that leg. Awesome. Let us see what others... Oh, the wolf missed us and we counterattacked, striking it in the paw with our axe. Censoring one of its sensory nerves, too. These are gonna be like the most gimped wolves ever. Alright, let's see what we can do here. Wolf missed us. But did it leave itself open to anything? No. So we're gonna pull back. We collide with it, knocking it over. Does this leave it open? Yes, a strike to the head. We might be able to kill it here. Oh! Knocking it to the ground, we leap upon it, smashing its skull with our axe, knocking it unconscious, and lodging our axe blade in its head, killing it, by all appearances. We retrieve our axe and back away. Seeing one of their members slain, the wolves decide that there would be easier prey found elsewhere, and we continue on our way. Man, it's gonna be getting dark here. Where are we on our... Alright, it's in the northeast of here. Oh, bugger. So, I'm assuming this is it right here. So, for the north. West. Alright, we are in the place we're supposed to be. So, we are actually going to stop and go down. Alright, we want to go south-southwest. And we are going to do so. And pray that we aren't surrounded by incessant cackling, because it'll be a cold day in hell before this dwarf sleeps above ground. And from here, we want to head to the south. What do we got here? Some loam. Ah, could use some rocks. Now, we're actually going to, we're going to want to keep an eye out, because there's probably an underground cave that we have to enter. That's what I'm going to assume. We can light trees on fire. We go south, southwest, south from here. South, southwest, south. Gotta be getting close. We're drowsy. It's been a busy day of trekking overland. Is this what we're looking for? Yes. Alright. The Hollow of Winnowing. Dang, just silty clay loam. I assume these are bone walls as well, yes. This is a dangerous place to be. Ah. Gulnest Burst Temples, the Wolf Ellipses. Stands before us, a massive wolf. Wonder how many of this one's killed. Alright. Come to me, Sir Wolf. Actually, I wanna check something here real quick. Alright, period is the wait key. Alright. We are going to attempt to strike it in the front paw with our axe. It seems to be an easy blow. Oh, we strike it in the front part with our copper battle axe and sever it. The gourd remains, strikes off in a bloody arc. And the wolf is knocked back and tumbles to the ground. We are going to attempt a strike on its right front leg. Having severed its paw, we just redouble our efforts and just screw its leg up really, really bad there. Does it leave itself open for anything else? I think we're gonna go for its left front leg. And we hack into that as well, severing a tendon and destroying the sensory nerves within. I don't even think this wolf has had a chance to attack us yet. Are we going to attempt to hack into its lower body? Oh, we do so, spilling the wolf's guts out onto the ground. It yelps in pain. And with that, we are going to strike at its left front leg again, trying to cut it off. We sever the motor nerve once more and destroy some more tendons. The wolf is no longer stunned, and we kind of reposition ourselves in an attempt to find a better position to attack from. There isn't one. And the wolf is attempting to escape. Oh, and she bleeds to death in doing so. I really wish you could, like, cut things' heads off, bring it back for proof. However, since we are in here, we're actually going to sleep here. We're going to sleep. Typically, I die when I do this, but I figured I might as well try. Alright. We appear to have survived the night with this wolf's corpse right there. Alright, there doesn't appear to be anything else here, so we are going to, go back outside. Day has dawned, and we are going to... we cannot travel from this site. We have to leave this immediate area. And, we're gonna go back and tell some townsfolk that we, took care of their wolf problem. Alright, far to the south once more. Uh-oh. You'll remember the fed onions when we're finished with you. Oh, I think we've been jumped by a bandit gang. Led by a warlord, carrying a silver battle axe and a bronze shield. She's skinny, hair is extremely long, brass eyes are very large. Irises, broad ears are flat, and her somewhat narrow nose is quite long. Her hair is gray with flecks of white, her skin sandy top. So this is a woman who has probably been at this for a while, and I assume she has people with us with her? Oh yes. What has she got? A spearman and Kopnut Zabshashibi. I am Kopnut Bronze Blossom. Who's prepared to die? I hope to God that was this person right here. Okay, it is. Alright, basically when they introduce themselves, that means that they're badass and we should probably run. Who's this? A crossbow. Oh god, that is the most dangerous opponent facing us right now. We're going to move in and attempt to kill him really damn fast. Just going to unleash. Oh, we struck him. Where did we get him? In the lower body, and our axe is lodged in the wound. We pull our axe out of him and move in to cut his arm off. We cut through his arm, but do not manage to sever it. We're going to keep just redoubling our efforts to kill this fool. Die. Alright, he's been knocked unconscious, and he has been struck down. Alright, that's all I care about. Alright. And I'm faster than these guys, so I can actually run around. I want to see if he has anything useful on him. I'm going to grab that crossbow, and I'm going to grab all those bolts, and I'm going to grab... do we have anything else worth anything here? No, we don't. Alright, so that's all we're going to grab. Now, I have absolutely no training in crossbows. However, we have nothing left to wear. I actually don't even know. What would you like to eat or drink? Nothing. Fire. You have nothing left to fire. Oh, come now. How do I equip that crossbow? Fire projectile. Remove what you're wearing. Put a knife in a container. Yaddy, yaddy, yaddy. Sneak travel. Alright, I missed it. Where is it? Wear an item W. I think I have to, what would you like to remove? Where is my sword? Not on the list. Alright, darn it. You have nothing left to wear. The sky is clear. Equip. No. Ready? No. Grr. Come now. Eat or drink, pick up, fire projectile, inventory, look around, put a knife in a container. Alright, maybe it's through inventory. Copper battle axe. No. Crossbow. Oh, come on. I could probably kill these guys if I could just... find the... Oh my god. Oh, that's her again. She's still taunting me. Trying to goad Aban into battling with a clearly superior foe who has a really nice axe that he would not mind owning. But I'm actually kind of more worried about that spearman that's following her around. Because, puncturing weapons are incredibly nasty in this game. Alright, he moved into our... And we are going to attempt a strike on his lower body. Oh, we chose poorly. We collide and tangle together, and the warlord is just taking advantage of this. We're stunned. Oh, god. Oh, and we are struck down. The warlord just easily dispatches us with that nice silver axe. The last thing poor Aban sees is that nice blade coming home right into his skull. And that is another character down. Finish. Yes. And, let's see, we're at 40 minutes, so I think this is where we're going to call this. This is kind of like a little test thing just to see how it goes over, so I hope you folks enjoyed it. And once it's done cleaning play objects here, I will finish stretching. Okay, come on now. Dwarf Fortress is not that hard. Alright. Alright, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I guess I will see you around.